Friday told me that anyone who clocked in even 1 minute of unauthorized overtime would be out of a proverbial job. Literally. And by anyone, they meant me. Dick Piston, hotel detective. Which is why at 10 minutes to midnight I'm here in my office, I've moved to the clock. When that strikes 12, my Friday night nightmares become somebody else's Saturday morning problem. My luck holds true. Ladybug, you've been such a watch fire.
I need your help.
I'm afraid I'm not the man you're looking for.
You're not Dick Piston.
No, I'm not helpful.
Well, you are the hotel detective.
Well, 9 more minutes I am, but there's not going to be a tenth, so I'm afraid if it's anything more time-consuming than a stuffed pickle jar, I'm going to have to refer you to the day shift.
Well, you have to help me. I'm a victim of a crime.
Well, unless that crime is unnecessary witness, I'm afraid there's not much I can do with the time allotted.
Not unnecessary witness.
Are you sure? Because I got a motor out of this.
Mr. Piston, you can't turn your back on me.
Not in that outfit.
Then you'll help me.
For 8 more minutes, I will, but that's all the time we got.
Will that be enough?
Depends on the crime, I suppose. Have a seat. What's yours?
I believe they call it murder.
Uh-huh. And you say that you're the victim?
Yes, it happened just now up in my hotel room.
You know what murder is, right?
Well, that's the one where somebody kills someone, isn't it?
That's the one?
I thought it was.
Oh, boy. All right, I'll tell you what. I'm going to take your case, but I'm also going to set this egg timer. When this goes off, case dismissed. No exceptions. We understood?
Yes, Mr. Piston. I can't tell you how grateful I am for this.
Coming here in that outfit is, thanks enough.
You're welcome.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to make a phone call.
Well, are you going to rush up to my room to examine the crime?
Ordinarily, I would, but we don't have that kind of time. Well, yeah, front desk. It's me, Dick Piston, hotel detective.
Excuse me, Piston. What are you doing?
Ordering room service.
Will that speed up the investigation?
Not at all.
Then why are you doing it?
Because no man in his right mind would ever be alone in a room with a woman in a room without at least a bottle of champagne and some whiskey on the way. Well, yeah, give me the honeymoon special sent to my office project. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Piston. How can I ever repay you?
I can think of one way.
Mr. Piston, I am a married woman.
You can never repay me then.
How do you know this was our honeymoon?
Just tell me about your partner and get on with it. If we make this quick, I might have time to Xerox a couple of resumes before morning.
All right. Well, I was up to my room taking a shower before dinner.
So you have any?
No, not yet. But those oysters sound delicious.
And the murder took place in the bathroom?
In the bedroom.
After your shower?
No, during.
So you were shot in the shower by someone in the bedroom?
What makes you think I was shot?
Well, because if it was a stabbing, you would have been in the same room as the killer.
My God, you think I was in the shower with me?
No, I think you were shot!
But I wasn't. Look.
Or stabbed, for that matter. But it does look like you've had a...
Well, considering you're not haunted anyway, have you ever been waxed? What makes you think you were murdered?
Oh, I was murdered. But you said you were.
I said I was a victim of a crime.
The crime was murder.
Oh, yes, very well, Mr. Piston. Your keen eye for detail will have the case set up in no time.
If you're the victim of a crime and the crime is murder, then why are you here?
Well, I have to report tonight. Who was my husband after all?
The killer?
No, the killer Reed.
The murder victim was your husband?
Yes.
So you're the victim of my marriage?
And this is supposed to be our honeymoon!
I see. Is that how you were dressed when you discovered the body?
Yes. I was taking a shower. Where I was new, Mr. Piston, can you imagine? Well, when I heard the sound of like gunshots and a blood-curdling scream, naturally I finished my shower, decided to throw on some makeup, but then I raced right out there to see what was the matter. That's when I saw him, dead on the bed with a slug in his head.
Were there any signs of, forced entry?
No, everything was perfectly normal. But except that awful dead body laying there.
You mean your husband?
Yes. That was his name. Guy.
Are you horrible?
Yes, it's right everywhere.
Well, Mr. Guy, ordinarily this is the point in the investigation where I would rush up to your hotel room to examine the evidence. But considering we're short on time, this just cuts the proverbial chase.
Room service!
Yes, Mr. Taylor! Oh, boy! How did you know that? Has your husband been clinically insane?
No, not clinically.
That's how I know.
I don't understand.
And there's no time to explain. No, wait, we got 4 minutes. Allow me to explain. There were no signs of forced entry. It can only mean that your husband let the killer into the room himself. So, he must have let someone that your husband personally or expected shortly. A bellhop, for example.
Why would my husband be expecting a bellhop?
Oh, because your husband was not clinically insane. And since no man in his right mind would ever be alone in a room with a woman in a row without at least a bottle of champagne and some oysters on the way, we know that he must have ordered something from room service.
It makes perfect sense.
And as you just witnessed, the service in this hotel is incredibly prompt.
I'm very impressed. We ought to make sure we leave him a big tip.
So, your husband's order must have arrived while you were still in the shower.
Yet,
you have any?
Because there wasn't any food.
Exactly. And if you never got the chance to enjoy, because after murdering your husband in cold blood and not wanting to leave any evidence that the killer was a member of the hotel staff, he removed the telltale oysters and champagne, something only a member of the hotel staff would do, leaving in their place the even more telltale absence of oysters and champagne, which confirms his guilt.
Why would this bellhop want to kill my husband?
Because unbeknownst to your late husband, this bellhop was having an extramarital affair with his wife.
You're married?
No, he was having an affair with you.
What makes you say that?
Because you still haven't asked me the one question that any widow in her right mind would want to know the answer to in this situation. Why did this bellhop want to kill your husband?
What I did ask.
You did? When?
Just now, Liz, just a second ago. I said it right away. It's practically the first thing that popped into my mind.
Probably didn't care for the detective either.